Hello dear students, in the previous session we were discussing the properties of del applying to point function, right? So let's continue with that. We have seen two properties. Now we will move to the third one, that is divergent curl F. Okay, so here don't get confused with these two notation. Here first I have curl, so this is something like, if I have curl F, I will denote that as del cross F, right? So in the place of F, I have grad F. So you will get del cross del F. Fine. Similarly, this is divergence curl F. Divergence means simply you can assume that as divergence of F, okay? So this is divergence of F. In the place of F, I have curl. So I can write this as del cross. Sorry. This is nothing but del dot curl F. Curl F is nothing but del cross F. So this is the difference between these two properties. Don't get confused, okay? So now we will prove the third property. What I will do is, this del is for I cap, J cap, K cap, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z. Or we can write this as I cap into dou by dou X1 plus J cap into dou by dou X2 plus K cap into dou by dou X3, right? So writing this is nothing but I can write summation I cap into dou by dou X. So for three different values, you can expand this summation, right? So rather writing in this form, I will just consider summation I cap into dou by dou X. That is nothing but my del. So this will be equal to summation I cap into dou by dou X dot. I have to write what is del F now, right? Sorry, it is del cross F. Curl F, right? So del cross F. I have to write what is curl F now. From the definition of curl, I know that del cross F is nothing but I cross dou F by dou X plus J cross dou F by dou Y plus K cap cross dou F by dou Z. Now let's multiply dou by dou X to these terms. So you will get, this is equal to summation I cap, I will retain as it is, into I cap cross dou square F by dou X square plus J cap cross into cross dou square F by dou X dou Y plus K cap cross dou square F by dou X dou Z. Now if I multiply these two, the I cap with these terms, I will get summation I cross I into dou square F by dou X square plus I cap cross J cap dot dou square F by dou X dou Y plus I cap cross K cap dot dou square F by dou X dou Z. Cross product will be for your vectors, not with your differential operator when you multiply, right? So that's why I cross I dot dou square F by dou X square, okay? So we have a property in our cross product. You might have studied that in your lower classes. that is I cap cross I cap, J cap cross J cap, K cap cross K cap will be equal to 0, and I cap cross J cap will be K cap, J cap cross K cap will be I cap, and J cross I cap will be minus K cap, and K cap cross J cap will be minus I cap. Similarly, we can consider K cap cross I cap as J cap, and I cap cross K cap will be minus J cap. These all are the properties of your cross product which you have studied in your BSc classes or in PU classes. Okay, so now I will use these properties here. So I cap I cross I cap is 0, so the notation becomes summation, I will write as it is. This whole term will become 0 since I cap cross I cap is 0. So this is I cap cross J cap. So I cross J is K cap into dou square F by dou X dou Y. Similarly, I have I cap cross K cap. I cap cross K cap is minus J cap. So this is minus J cap into dou square F by dou X dou Z. So this will be equal to summation K cap into dou square F by dou X dou Y minus summation J cap dou square F by dou X dou Z. So you can write it 0 directly, or if you are not able to understand that how it will become 0, you can write this step. Since I have summation, I should write 3 terms, right? So you can observe here I have K cap. In your differential term there is no Z term, so when I write I cap there will be no X, when I write J cap there will be no Y. So if I expand this, I will get I cap into dou square F by dou Y dou Z plus J cap into dou square F by dou X dou Z plus K cap into dou square F by dou X dou Y. Similarly, I have minus of, so I have J cap, there is no Y term here. So I cap into dou square F by dou Y dou Z plus J cap dou square F by dou X dou Z plus K cap into dou square F by dou X dou Y. Right? So see here, I cap dou square F by dou Y dou Z minus dou square F by dou Y dou Z gets cancelled. Similarly, these two terms gets cancelled and these two terms gets cancelled. So finally, you will get the solution as 0. Okay, so therefore, del dot del cross F is equal to 0. Now let's move to the fourth property, that is curl curl F. Curl curl F is equal to gradient divergence F minus del square F. This is what we have to prove. In order to prove these properties, we will use one of the important property from vector product of three vectors. Okay, so if we have three vectors, how we can do the vector product? We have some properties. We will use that properties here to prove this property. Okay, So I will write the properties first. This is the property I will use now, okay? Even in the previous problem, here from I dot I cap cross dou square f by dou x square plus j cap cross dou square f by dou x dou y plus k cap cross dou square f by dou x dou z. Here also you have one property, and here we will use the property which is for scalar product of three vectors. Okay, so the property was which I have used here. So let's use this property now. We will get, this is my curl f, right? So for del, I will write summation I cap dou by dou x cross. I know what is del cross f. So this is nothing but I cap cross dou f by dou x plus j cap cross dou f by dou y plus k cap cross dou f by dou z. Now let's multiply dou by dou x to these terms. You will get summation I cap cross I cap in cross dou square f by dou x square plus j cap cross dou square f by dou x dou y plus k cap cross dou square f by dou x dou z. Okay, so now I can use this property. This is my A, this is B, this is C. So if I use this property here, I will get A dot C means I cap dot, I have summation I cap dot dou square f by dou x square into b. B is again I cap minus a dot b means I dot I into c is dou square f by dou x square. This is my first term. Similarly, for this I cap cross j cap cross dou square f by dou x dou y, this will become a is I cap c is dou square f by dou x dou y b is j cap minus a is I cap dot j cap into dou square f by dou x dou y. Right. Similarly, I have one more term, that is I dot dou square f by dou x dou z into k cap minus I cap dot k cap into dou square f by dou x dou z. So we have these three terms now, right? If you simplify this step, you will get this will be equal to summation. So first term I will retain as it is, I cap dot dou square f by dou x square into I cap, right? So in this term, I cap dot I cap is 1 into dou square f by dou x square. So since I have no vectors, that is unit vector, the summation will apply only for dou square f by dou x square. So since I have only one term, I will retain this term at the end. Okay, so let's continue with these. Now I will write this term as it is. I dot j is 0 and again I dot k is 0. So you will get plus I cap dot dou square f by dou x dou y into j cap plus I cap dot dou square f by dou x dou z into k cap. And the last time I have is summation dou square f by dou x square. Alright, so now I can write this whole term as summation I cap into dou by dou x of I cap into dou f by dou x plus j cap into dou f by dou y plus k cap into dou f by dou z minus summation dou square f by dou x square. In these term I have taken I cap into dou by dou x as common. Okay, so now this will be equal to, this is nothing but del into, here I have I cap dou f by dou x plus j cap dou f by dou y plus k cap dou f by dou z. This is nothing but your divergence, that is del dot f, minus this is nothing but del square f, right? Laplacian operator. I can express this as Laplacian operator, that is del square f. So this is nothing but your property 4. You can observe here, del into del dot f minus del square f. So we have proved the property 4. Now let's move to property 5. Here you can observe your property 4 and property 5. Property 5 is nothing but expressing your property 4 in another way. That's it. So here I have written in curl curl f form. Here I have written in gradient divergence f form. So you need not to prove this. If you know this, you can write this. Okay. Now let's move to some other properties. That is del applied to products of point function. First we have studied del applied twice to point function. So here del applied products of point function. See, you can observe here f and g are point function. This is product of point function. Product. We have product all over there, right? So let's prove one by one. The first property is del of f g is equal to f del g plus g del f. This is what I have to prove. So del f g means, let's take the LHS side, del f g, I can write del f g as summation I cap into dou by dou x of f g, right? So this is nothing but product rule of differentiation I have to do here. So I will get summation I cap into f into dou g by dou x plus g into dou f by dou x, right? So this is nothing but f into summation I cap dou g by dou x plus g into summation I cap dou f by dou x. So let's return f at as it is. Summation I cap dou g by dou x is nothing but del g plus g, I will write as it is. Summation I cap into dou f by dou x is nothing but del f. So this is your property 1. Now let's move to property 2. This is our second property. Again consider LHS. This is del dot fg. So if I write it in summation form, this is nothing but summation I cap dot dou by dou x of fg. Again use product rule of differentiation. So you will get summation I cap into f into dou g by dou x plus जी इंटू डो एफ बाई डो एक्स. सो आई कैन राइट दिस एज समेशन एफ इंटू समेशन आई कैप. मेक अ स्मॉल करेक्शन, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू समेशन आई कैप इंटू डो जी बाई डो एक्स डॉट एफ प्लस समेशन आई कैप इंटू डो एफ बाई डो एक्स डॉट जी. राइट, सो आई हैव फर्स्ट एफ टर्म, सो यू कैन राइट उल्टा ऑफ दिस ऑल्सो. सो वी विल गेट डेल जी डॉट एफ प्लस डेल एफ डॉट जी. इन अदर वर्ड्स यू कैन राइट एफ इंटू डेल डॉट जी प्लस डेल एफ डॉट जी. सो फर्स्ट वॉट वी हैव डन, आई हैव कंसिडर्ड आई कैप डॉट डो बाई डो एक्स ऑफ एफ जी. ओके, सो फॉर दिस वी हैव अप्लाइड द प्रोडक्ट रूल ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन. यू विल गेट दिस, यू कैन राइट दिस एज इन वन मोर वे यू कैन राइट, दैट इज समेशन आई कैप डॉट डो एफ बाई डो एक्स जी प्लस एफ इंटू डो जी बाई डो एक्स ऑल्सो. राइट, सो नाउ दिस विल बिकम आई कैप डो एफ बाई डो एक्स डॉट जी. दिस इज वन टर्म. अनदर टर्म इज आई कैप डॉट डो जी बाई डो एक्स इंटू एफ. ओके, सो नाउ दिस इज नथिंग बट make a correction here. So now this is nothing but this term is del f dot g as it is plus I can write this as f into summation I cap dot dou g by dou x. Right, so this is equal to del f dot g plus f into del dot g. I have dot here, right? So this is the required result. Let's discuss the remaining properties in the next session. Okay, thank you.